Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 4-94 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler. So statement is the resulting stress distribution along section AB for the bar is shown. From this distribution, determine the approximate resultant axial force P applied to the bar. Also, what is the stress concentration factor for this geometry? So you can see this is a bar having fillet, clear, and at section AB the stress distribution is shown like that, clear, and there is a P load applied to this bar. So you can see the highest intensity is 12 KSI, and the intensity of each of this segment is 3 KSI. So there are 4 segments, and if we count it, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 approximately square bar. The thickness of this bar is 0.5 inch. So let's start with the solution. So as we know that this P load is equal to integral of stress into dA. So what does it mean? It means that volume under curve. So where is the curve? So you can see this is the curve, clear. So volume of this curve will be like this one. Okay, so how we'll find this? So let's start solving this problem. So as we know that I have already discussed that number of square in this volume is equal to 10. Let me count it again. So you can see 1 square, 2 and 3 plus 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So approximately there are 10 square. So we know that P will be equal to, you can see the intensity of one is 3 KSI. So 3 multiplied by the area. What is the area? So 1 is the height of this and 0.5 is the thickness. So 1 into 0.5. So there are 10 squares, so I will multiply it with 10. So it will give you the P load, which is the volume under the curve. And when you calculate it, it will be equal to 15 kips. So I will write P will be equal to 15 kips, which is the answer of our first part. Clear? Now we'll find the stress concentration factor. I will write it stress concentration factor K. So we know that due to this fillet, there will be a maximum stress at this fillet portion, clear, and minimum stress or stress will be at the middle. So what we will going to do is that we will find this stress concentration factor. So we know that this maximum stress will be equal to stress concentration factor into sigma average. So how you will find sigma average? So sigma average is equal to P divided by A. Now what is P? So P is 15 kips. So 15 kip multiply by what is the area of this portion? So this is thickness 0.5 and total height is 4 inch. So this will be the cross-sectional area over which this P act. So P divided by 4 inch multiply by 0.5 inch, and when you calculate it, it will be 7.5 KSI. Okay. So from here, sigma average is equal to 7.5 KSI. So what we are going to do is that we will find this K, clear? So how we'll find this K? You will need average maximum stress. So maximum stress can be taken from curve, and that maximum stress is 12 KSI. So sigma max is equal to 12 KSI. So we know that maximum stress is equal to K into sigma average. So from here, this K will be equal to sigma max divided by sigma average. So put the value, sigma max is 12 KSI and sigma average is 7.5 KSI, which will give you 1.60. So the stress concentration factor is 1.60 required stress concentration factor for this bar, which is the answer of our this question. And that was all about this problem 4-94. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. Also, share my videos with your friends and help them in learning process. And I am very thankful to you people for supporting me throughout my this journey on YouTube channel. Thank you.